With the new release of Intercompany Integration Solution 2.0 for SAP Business One 9.0, the Administration Console has been extended to support a Company Template Configurator. A Company Template Configurator allows users to create custom integration templates that can be assigned to their branch companies within their intercompany landscape. These company templates define the set of data replication definitions for a business object, such as a table structure or a field type. Users can then decide to send or receive these particular business objects within the intercompany landscape. Users can further decide to accept these specific objects by adding, updating, or deleting them within the Business One company. Inbox notifications of these business transactions can also be configured for these objects using the Company Template Configurator. Our company, OEC Computers, have branches all over Switzerland, and these branches are localized Business One company databases to meet local business practices. For this scenario, we have three Swiss localization companies. Head office is based in Zurich, Branch 1 is based in Geneva, and Branch 2 is based in Bern. We are going to configure data replication for two business objects, business partner priority and shipping type for each branch. OEC Computers prioritize their customers based on specific criteria. Head office in Zurich and the Geneva branch share the same definitions for prioritizing their business partners. Branch 2 in Bern, however, uses additional customer priority definitions to meet the needs of their own local target market. In addition, shipping company agreements are negotiated on behalf of all three companies nationwide, and therefore each OEC company uses the same shipping types. So in order to meet these specific business requirements and share the appropriate data across each company, we need to configure customized templates for these branches. So we're going to show you how easy it is to configure, customize, and use the templates defined with the Company Template Configurator. The first thing we need to do is log in to the Intercompany Integration Administration Console. To do this, I add in my B1i user details and my appropriate password. We're now logged in to the Integration Solution for SAP Business One Administration Console. And to access the Company Template Configuration window, we simply select Setup from the top menu and then select Company Template from the left-hand frame. The Company Template Configuration window is now displayed. Under the Template Name field, we can select the Browse button, and now we're going to choose a default template. We now need to select the localization for this default template, which is going to be for Switzerland. As you can see now, the company template configuration details are now displayed. We're now going to customize this template for our Zurich head office and Geneva branch companies. The default template cannot be modified, and therefore we need to copy the default template by selecting the Copy button. Now that we've copied the template, we can make changes according to OEC's business requirements for their Swiss companies. Under Master and Business Cycle, we have a list of all the master and business cycles available for configuration. The mandatory master business cycles are displayed in red, and these are not editable. We then have a list of receiver property lists. You can select the receiver property list button to view the receiver property replication details, which we will show you shortly. Under replication, if you want to send this particular business object event to a Business One company within the intercompany landscape, you need to select the Send checkbox. Similarly, to receive this business object event, you need to select the Receive checkbox. Then under Receiver action, We have a number of actions such as add, update, or delete. You need to select the appropriate checkboxes if you want to receive the add, update, or delete action events. To also receive the success or failure notifications in your inbox, you need to select the appropriate checkboxes as well. For our head office in Zurich and our branch in Geneva, we would like to replicate some business partner properties, and to do this, we need to select the business partner master list. We're going to select the receiver property list under business partners. And here under the object property configuration window, we're now presented with a list of all of the property names. Again, the names in red cannot be modified. Next to the property name, we have the object which is linked to the property. And then we have the replicate checkbox, which needs to be checked for object replication. So we would like to include the replication of the business partner priority and shipping types for the head office and Geneva branch company databases. To do this, we simply scroll down and find the business partner priority object. And we check the replication checkbox. We now need to find the shipping type. And again, we check the replication checkbox. Now all we need to do is simply save these property details. Once that has been saved successfully, we can see under our master and business cycle events that, for example, the business partner priority event has been added to our template. If we scroll down to shipping type, we can also see that the shipping type receiver property list has been added to our template as well. So now we've completed the configuration of our first template, we're going to rename the template name to Template A, and we're going to save it. We're now going to create a new template that we're going to assign to the Bern branch company because we do not want to replicate any business partner priorities that are created within the Bern branch company. And to do this, I'm going to copy the template A that we've just created. And now we're going to uncheck, if we go down to Business Partner Priority, we're going to uncheck the send event. And what this means is that any business partner priority defined in this business partner master of the branch company will not be replicated to other branch companies. So now I've customized and configured this template for our Bern branch. I'm going to rename this template as Template B. And now we can save the template. So now we have configured two customized templates, one for the Zurich head office and Geneva branch office, and another one for the Bern branch office. We can now assign these templates to the relevant companies within our intercompany landscape. To do this, we need to select the landscape option in the left-hand frame. And as you can see, the intercompany landscape window is displayed. And this lists all of our companies which are associated with our intercompany landscape. As you can see, by default, the default company template is available to all company databases. So now we need to assign the newly created custom templates that we created to OEC's head office and branch one companies, and also to the Bern branch. To do this, we select the Browse button next to the company that we want to assign the template to. And then we change the company template from the default template to Template A. As you can see now, template A is now assigned against our head office company database based in Zurich. We're going to do the same thing for branch 1 for our Geneva branch. We're going to select template A. And finally, against our Bern branch, branch 2, we're going to select template B that we created specifically for our Bern branch. Now that we've made changes within the intercompany landscape, we actually need to deploy the solution. And in order to do that, we simply check the deploy button. So now that we have assigned the templates and deployed the solution successfully, let's move to SAP Business One to perform a business partner replication to actually see the effect of these applied configuration templates. We are now logged in to the head office company system with an assigned custom template for data replication. OEC Computers have just negotiated an agreement with a new shipping company called Time Express Couriers. So we're going to create a new shipping type in the system. To do this, we navigate to Administration, Setup, Inventory, Shipping Types. Our shipping type is called Time Express Couriers. And now we can select Update. Under Business Partner Master Data, we're now going to add a new business partner. We're going to navigate to Business Partners and open up the Business Partner Master Data window. In Add mode, we're now going to add a new business partner code. And the name of our business partner is Walter White. We're going to assign the new shipping type that we just created to this business partner, Time Express Couriers. Under the Payment Terms tab, under Priority, if we drop down our priority list, we can see all of the current priority categories, and we're going to define a new category called Very High and assign it to this new customer as well. And now we can update our business partner priorities. And we can see that the priority Very High has now been assigned to this new customer as well. Back in the General tab, the last thing we need to do is now define this business partner as a global business partner, so it's replicated across our other branches. And now we can add the business partner to the system. Let's now log in to our Branch 2 company based in Bern to view the Business Partner Object Replication results. We are now logged in to our Branch 2 system. And as you can see in our Alerts window, we have three intercompany notifications. The first intercompany notification is the shipping type that we added. We can open up the shipping type window, and as you can see, the new shipping type, Time Express Couriers, has also been replicated into our Bern branch. The second intercompany notification is about BP priorities, and it indicates that a new business partner priority has been added successfully. And then we have our business partner intercompany notification. If we click on business partner, we now have the ability to drill down into the new business partner that was replicated. You can now see that the business partner properties, such as the shipping type, has been replicated. And if we go to the payment terms tab, the business partner priority that we created in the head office was also replicated to this particular customer and to the Bern branch. The OEC branch in Bern have additional business partner priorities they use for their local target market. We are going to define a new business partner priority in branch 2. Since we have disabled the Business Partner Priority Send event for this company, any new Business Partner Priorities defined from Branch 2 will not be replicated to other branch companies because they're not relevant to other branches. So to do this, we're actually going to go into Administration, Setup, and under Business Partners, we're going to open up the Business Partner Priorities window. We're now going to create a new Business Partner Priority for Branch 2 called VIP. Let's now log back into our head office company system and see what the results of the replication are. We're now logged back into our head office company system, and as you can see, no intercompany alert has been displayed. And if we go under Administration, Setup, Business Partners, and we open up the Business Partner Priority window, we can see that this new priority created in Branch 2 has not been replicated. Intercompany Integration Solution Release 2.0 for SAP Business One 9.0 allows users to define the data replication parameters for each business object by simply configuring the intercompany templates using the Company Template Configurator. This allows companies with a complex intercompany landscape to have greater control over data to be replicated and makes the process easy to manage and maintain with a growing intercompany landscape.